We are nearly done with our model, but still need to set up the textures. The main thing to understand is that we will set up two textures on a single material. The first is the diffuse texture, the second is the normal map. If you aren't sure what a diffuse texture or normal map is, I recommend watching the video regarding basic texture types. We've already set up our VMT file, so let's start by adding a diffuse texture. But how do we know what diffuse texture we need to use? Let's go into Blender and take a closer look at the material. Select the relevant model part and go down to the Materials tab to select the right material slot. We only have one, so we only have to drag out a new panel and switch to the Shader Editor workspace. Here we can see that we have a really basic principal shader with a few textures. It's safe to say that the one that's plugged into the base color will probably be the diffuse. Take note of the texture name. As you can see, in our case, it's a PNG file. We will need to convert this to VTF. So open up VTF Edit. To open any non-VTF image file, go to File, Import, and pick your image from the file window. This in turn will open up a window with various options for the texture. If you are technically minded, you might want to tweak these settings. However, we will just keep the defaults and just hit OK. Great, our diffuse texture is loaded into VTF Edit. Now we save it next to our VMT file using File, Save. I'm going to save it in the same directory as the materials VMT file. Since the name contains some gibberish, I'm going to name it the same as the VMT file, but without the extension and with underscore diff added at the end. VTF Edit will automatically add the .vtf extension once you hit save. Now we return to our VMT file. Remove the color2 entry. We're going to replace this VMT command with a new one, $base texture. The base texture parameter sets the path to our diffuse texture. This path is, as you guessed it, relative to the materials directory. We enter the path, including our texture name, in quotes. You don't have to include the extension here. Source only loads VTF files, so it will add it automatically. Save the file, and let's hop over and refresh the model in HLMV. Yes, there she is! Now for the normal map. We also need to convert that, but we have a bunch of other textures on the model we have to do as well. And that process we just went through is kind of tedious. So let's just convert all the textures ahead of time. Go to Tools, Convert, Folder. Set the input and export folders to be the texture folder in our workspace. Set the button at 2VTF. In the field next to it, we see this text box with the asterisk pattern again. We've seen this before. It says asterisk.png, so it will search for all the PNG files in the input directory. So if your textures are in a different format, replace PNG with the format your textures are in, JPEG, GIF, or TGA. You can also hit recursive, so it will go through all the subdirectories too. And as VTF Edit writes very specific VMT files, we don't want to create VMT files in this case. You can optionally tweak the VTF options, but there's no need in our case. Time to hit convert. This may take a while, since we'll convert a bunch of large files. Once it's done, take a quick peek at the name of the normal map in Blender, and find the resulting VTF file in our textures directory. Copy it, rename it in the same manner as we did the diffuse, but instead of diff, add nrm. Now we write this instruction into our VMT file. We do this with the bump map command. You can just duplicate the line from before and change base texture to bump map and adjust the path to the normal map texture. Refreshing the model in HLMV won't show a difference because we need to enable normal mapping in the render tab. The result should be immediate. Look at the creases as you move the light. Excellent. From here, you can add more material parameters like fog shading or transparency, but that's something for a different tutorial series. But wait, we still have to get the hair and outfit in there. How do we do that? Let's go back to our export folder. We have the hair and outfit files. Let's add those to the QC file. We could do this with another $model instruction like before, but in this case, we want to be able to turn those parts on and off. That's when we use the bodygroup command. The bodygroup command takes two parameters. First is a name, just like the model command. This defines the name of the bodygroup, so we know how to find it. In our case, we want to add one for the hair. The second parameter is a list of sorts. We write this on a new line and use the curly brackets to indicate that this is a block containing the list. The most simple list item is the blank item. Writing blank is the equivalent of having an option to turn this part of the model off. For every option in the body group that is an actual model, you start by writing studio, followed by a space, and then the SMD file you want to add. The first option on the list is the default option when the model is first loaded. So I wrote the hair mesh there, since we want to enable it by default. You can later turn it off with the blank option. Compile your model and refresh it in the viewer. There's the hair geometry. It's got a separate material, so it has the checkerboard texture as expected. But we know the geometry imported fine, so we can add another body group for the outfit. Same as before. Write the body group, recompile, refresh. There's the outfit. Now set up the materials for these parts. Same as before. Create a VMT file for the added materials dots on your model, copy and rename the VTF files, and write the base texture and bump map in the VMT file. Let's check the model in Source Filmmaker. Yep, it appears to be working. And with that, we conclude this series on making a simple SFM model. There's much more we can do to improve this model and its materials. It probably doesn't look as good as the best models you'll find on SFM Lab. But remember, VMT files are just text files. You can look at other people's settings and materials and take inspiration from their work. You can also look at the Valve Developer Wiki for more advanced shader effects and QC commands. If you have suggestions about what subject you want the next tutorial series to be about, leave them in the comments below. And if you run into issues, visit our Discord server. Links are in the description. Subscribe for future videos. Pledge to the Patreon to support my work. Thank you for watching. Thank you.